Hello friends, in this video I will discuss about mucormycosis in detail. Mucormycosis is a kind of fungal disease caused by mucormycetes, which is a kind of filamentous fungus, and they belong to family Mucoraceae. Mucormycetes are present in environment, particularly in soil having decaying organic matters such as leaves, manure and animal dung. They are also found in air as well as in food items. Every day we come in contact with such types of fungal spores, so it is impossible to completely avoid coming in contact with mucormycetes. So please don't be panic, as these fungi are not harmful for the most of the people. But for the people who have weakened immune system, if they inhale mucormycetes spores, can cause an infection to the lungs and sinus, which can spread to the other parts of the body, including brain. Patients who are suffering from diabetes, particularly diabetes ketoacidosis, and infected by HIV, cancer, and have organ transplant as well as stem cell transplant, as well as those patients who are taking steroid long term, are more vulnerable to get infected by black fungus. The one relevant thing I want to emphasize here, the use of corticosteroid for COVID patients. Why corticosteroids are used to treat COVID patients and how it downgrades your immune system. Coronavirus causes inflammation of larynx, trachea, bronchi and lungs, resulting in difficulties in both tracheal intubation and extubation, which leads breathing difficulties, and all these things lead low level of oxygen saturation and need urgent treatment. While using corticosteroid for COVID patient, timing is very critical factor, and your consulting physician decide the doses and duration to use it. In India, misuse of steroid is very common. Recently, I have watched many doctors on TV debates suggested to use steroid to the patients infected by COVID, but they forget to mention when it should be used and who can use it and who cannot use steroid at all. The important point, you need to know how corticosteroid downgrade your immune system. For that, you need to understand the mechanism of action of corticosteroids. Corticosteroids inhibit cyclooxygenase 2. This leads reduction of migration of leukocytes to the inflammatory sites. It inhibit transcription factors including macrophages, lymphocyte, mast cells and dendrite cells. Also inhibits phospholipase A2, which is responsible for production of numerous inflammatory mediators. They also promote anti-inflammatory genes like interleukin. Since corticosteroids prevent migration of leukocytes, leukocytes are also known as WBC and are the cells of immune system that are involved in protecting the body against infectious disease and foreign invaders. The blockage of WBC means white blood cells in resulting weaken the immune system. There are lots of medical terms have been used and you may find it difficult to understand. But if I describe each and every word, will considerably increase the length of video. Now again moving to the main topic, mucormycosis. Mode of transmission means how does mucormycosis spread. Please note that mucormycosis is not a contagious disease, so it cannot transmit between people and animals. If someone inhaled spores of mucormycetes, can infect the lungs and sinus. Other way, if the fungus enters the skin through a cut, scrape, burns or other types of skin trauma, mucormycosis can also develop on the skin, and this infection can subsequently spread to the bloodstream and reach organs like heart, brain and spleen. Symptoms of mucormycosis. I have taken some images from internet, hope these are not restricted to any copyright. And the prominent symptoms of the mucormycosis are listed on the screen. Fever, nasal bleeding, black lesions on the bridge of your nose, black lesions inside mouth, coughing, shortness of breath, swelling on one side of face, swelling around eyes, GIT bleeding and blood in the stool. Diagnosis and testing of mucormycosis. Your physician who suspect that you have mucormycosis in your lungs or sinus may collect a sample of fluid from your respiratory system and send it to the laboratory for testing. Also, your healthcare provider may perform a tissue biopsy. Other way to diagnose mucormycosis, imaging test also can be performed like CT scan. Treatment for mucormycosis. Some medicines are listed on the screen and all are the prescription medicines. On the basis of CVRT, your consulting doctor decides if you need injectable or oral drug. In severe cases, surgery also needed. Prevention. Here I will quote a famous proverb. Prevention is always better than cure. So try your best to save yourself from this deadliest fungus. And here I have listed some preventive measures. Avoid to go dusty and construction sites. Wear N95 mask. Take healthy diet. Restrict intake of sugar and salt. Strictly control your blood sugar level and blood pressure. Perform yoga and meditation. Thank